both sets of supporters, and the game will be underway very shortly. Certainly this is a very, very impressive venue, quite a sight to behold. Toulouse haven't been having the best of times recently, no points in the last nine available.
Well, they've hit a very worrying run of form, Peter, that needs to be arrested quite quickly, or they may take on a reputation of being the whipping boys from here. It's time to get back to basics and be a more competitive proposition. Getting the defence organised and a focus on clean sheets can help stop the rot and help them step away from it. And I hope the manager hasn't overindulged in meetings, because that can drive players mad.
Towering header! Big moment! Massive goal!
Listen, the big names earn their reputations for precisely the reason we've just seen. They have a habit of making their presence felt. And here we are, early stages. He struck wood, and he looks hungry for more.
Oh, lovely header, but really, it was all about the delivery.
Oh, look, it's often the timing of the jump that dictates what you can do with any header. And if you get it slightly wrong, then you'll struggle, but that was a beautifully met.
Saint-Germain have an early lead. Good start.
Toulouse lost their first three games. 3 points now, very necessary, both in terms of table position and morale.
He'll hit it! He's got away with one there.
Well, one sloppy lapse like that can do a lot of damage, and it was triggered by the closing down.
Fouled. Seems now to be all about width.
Well, when you have the personnel to create in wide areas, then they need to see as much of the ball as possible.
Timely intervention.
Really wasn't very much in there, far away from being a telling final ball.
Look, the game is full of ifs and buts. If only the pass could have completed its journey.
Real chance to break. Nicely measured pass.
Sevi.
He's made sure that that won't get through.
Toulouse seek a performance here which reflects rather better on the boss. He's taken a fair amount of criticism in the wake of the last game.
Look, some of the scrutiny is a bit over.
It's one! Had a swing, but it wasn't to be.
Ah, that's unlucky. The idea was really smart for me, and he's had a good go at it.
Verratti,
Mbappe, shot a goal! He's not concerned by that.
Well, I think a little eagerness just got the better of him. He may have been thinking about back page headlines there.
Sergio Ramos, and it's Neymar.
Paris Saint-Germain scored early, of course, and the score is 1-0.
Up he gets! He scores! A two-goal lead, and they're firmly in control.
Saint-Germain are really pouncing on any straight passes in midfield. We're talking seconds from interception to the back of the net. It's counter-attacking heaven.
Saint-Germain take a two-goal lead and things should be comfortable from here on in.
Well, that second goal has given them so much more command and confidence now, and they should be able to take it on from here and either add to their lead or close it out. Surely they'll manage one or the other.
Just needed to be better than that, and he knows it. Forward it goes.
Sergio Ramos. Kozawa.
Coming up to half-time, leading, and things are looking pretty good. Marco Verratti.
Verratti!
Oh, that's a waste.
Well, it was hit with great power, Peter, but sadly, not great precision.
Sorted that out. Out wide to the right. Marco Verratti. Aimed long and direct. Gets it upfield. Referee brings the first half to a close. Views on the first half?
Well, it's looking pretty straightforward, Peter. They've got themselves into a very good position, so why dither from here when they can repeat their first half success with another show of strength?
Paris Saint-Germain hit 2-0.
Mbappe!
He's there to make a great save.
Well, what can I say? Truly wonderful goalkeeping.
A corner taker. Stitch defending, but that'll do. Gradle plays it forward. He's picked him out. He's left his man. It's anyone's ball. It's wrestled off the ball. Defense got better of him this time, but I'm sure he'll go again.
A finish right from the top draw. And the lead is extended still further.
Oh, my goodness, that has ripped the rigging.
Yeah, I just thought he made great use of his upper body. It would have taken something really special to do that.
Shot away! Great strike.
That Di Maria put absolutely everything he had into that. Maybe better look next time. Sacrifices some power, he may control the elevation.
Oh, now some movement on the bench, and we are going to see a change. It's Dosevi. Dosevi.
It's Dosevi!
Has to get it forward quickly. He's brushed off the ball there.
Verratti plays it forward. Bia hit the slide tackle there.
He's had a look.
Aimed low and direct.
Forward it goes.
Surely he scores. Has a swing at it.
Di Maria plays it forward.
He's not going to get that.
Tries to dink it in.
Oh, well defended. That had to be done.
Bia is the guilty party there.
Let's be lenient here. He'll get too many more chances.
Was more possible than probable, and the outcome backed it up, Peter.
Just the goalkeeper. Mbappe! And it's there! Players ecstatic, fans delirious. This is utopian.
A momentary lapse, exploited with glee.
Just required a bit more oomph to reach its target. This defence is wary about opposition pace.
So they're just not getting too tight?
Yeah, they know that if they step up, they...
Speculative strike!
That's wide.
Well, Peter, he clearly felt he was being invited to shoot, and it wasn't the worst decision he could have made.
That's a poor kick by the keeper, he's just given it straight back. Has a look and has a go. Oh, great effort, but he's produced a save to match. There goes the final whistle.
Paris Saint-Germain,
a class apart. Opponents torn apart. They are comprehensive winners.
So
Jim, how do you reflect on what we've seen?
Paris Saint-Germain simply imposed their strength from start to finish.